Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and this is the 2025 Surface Pro 12. It's a little bit smaller this year and comes in at $799 and goes up to $899 depending on the CPU and the overall storage. Now we have three different colors this year: violet, ocean, and platinum. This is the new violet color, and you can see on the back that we have the Surface Pro 12 First Edition Snapdragon X Plus, 16 gigs of RAM, and 512 gigs of storage. So again, that's what's included. Let's go ahead and open it up. So we'll pull the tab on the front here and open it up. Of course, I have the keyboard here as well as the Surface Pen. So let's set those aside. Let's open it up and see what we've got. This is my first time seeing it. And this is that new violet color, like I mentioned. Let's take it out here and we'll set it aside just for a moment. See what else we get in the box here with it. So it looks like we've got a USB-C to USB-C cable. Pretty heavy duty, rubberized, no sort of woven coating on it or anything like that. And then in the box, it looks like that's all we've got. So not even a power adapter there. And then inside here, it looks like we've got just basically about your Surface is compatible with a minimum 27 watt USB-C charger. And then here, maybe a quick start guide where the pen can go and about the ports. So not a whole lot going on here, and I'm surprised we don't even get a charger with it. I suppose most people do have a 27 watt charger, but that's something I really did not expect from this. So this does not open at all, and we don't have that included. So something I'm a little disappointed with, but it's not included here. Let's go ahead and check one more time. Again, none of this moves, so that's what's included. We'll set this aside, and let's take a closer look at the Surface itself. So again, we'll slide that over, and the keyboard we'll take a look at in a little bit. So we'll take this cover off the front here, and you can see that we have a camera here. We've got our microphone, as well as our power sleep wake button. And again, let's pull this cover off the front. There we go. So there's the display. You can see it's pretty reflective overall. Let's take a look around the outside edge. So we have our power sleep wake button. We've got our volume button. They're rubberized here. Nothing else really on that side. On the bottom, we've got two USB-C, or it could be the right side, however you're holding it, but we've got two USB-C ports. Now these USB-C ports are not 4.0 ports, but they're rather 3.2 ports. So that's something that's a little bit different. Then on the bottom, we have our connector for our keyboard. And then on the other side, nothing else. So no USB-A and no Surface connector either. If we open up the back here, see if we can open this up. We don't have expandable storage here, so whatever you order it with is what you get, but we do have the durable stand, so you can push on it like this, it won't break it, it will hold, and then you can place it in different orientations. Of course, we've got the cutout for the pen, and then we have a camera on the back. The rear camera is a 10 megapixel Ultra HD camera, and then the front camera is a 1080p camera. You can see a couple microphones here, and then we have a couple speaker cutouts around the outside bezel. The bezel looks pretty sort of similar around the whole outside edge, and that's what we get with the new Surface Pro. Now let's go ahead and turn it on and we'll talk about the display. So that turned on pretty quickly, and what we have is a 12-inch PixelSense LCD display. It's 2196 by 1464, 220 pixels per inch. It's up to 90 hertz, and it's 60 hertz by default. It's sRGB and enhanced and goes up to 400 nits. It's not Gorilla Glass, they don't say what it is, and it is 10-point multi-touch like all the others. Now, according to Microsoft, these ports can support up to two 4K displays externally up to 60 hertz. So that's what you've got here. Now it says just a moment. Let's see if it changes. There we go. It changes orientation. We'll wait for it to boot up here just a moment. So there's our boot up sound. We've got the display there and we're ready to set it up. We'll do that in just a moment. But as far as the display, like I said, it's very reflective. Now the processor is said to be 50% faster than the Surface Pro 9. We have Wi-Fi 7 internally, and the whole design is made of aluminum or aluminium and 100% recycled cobalt in the battery cells. So that's something that's updated. No headphone jack and nothing else. It's 1.5 pounds or 686 grams. Now let's set this aside just for a moment so that we can unbox the keyboard, get this all taken care of, and then set up the display. So you'll see this comes in at about $150. Now it's the Microsoft Surface Pro 12-inch keyboard. No other keyboard is compatible with it. Let's go ahead and open it up here. And you'll see on the back, nothing really there. And then we'll open it like this. So it does match. You can get them in matching colors. We have the keyboard itself and just a little paper here. So it tells you how to attach it. And then on the back, it shows that it just has the AI experiences as it's a CoPilot Plus PC. So you have the button there. So let's set that aside here. Set the box up here. And you can see this looks pretty good. We don't have Alcantara here for the palm rests anymore. The overall trackpad is fairly clicky. So take a listen. The keyboard looks good. It has very similar feel to pretty much any of the Surface keyboards. Nice feedback there. And then along the top here, we have, of course, our normal keys, along with a few others with volume and brightness and more. On the back, though, it is still Alcantara, so it matches the overall device if that's what you choose. And then it's more flat this time around, so it's less angled and it stays flat on the desk. Then you can use the stand on the back and then angle it however you'd like. So that's what we've got there. It feels pretty rigid, and together with the overall device, it looks pretty good. So this is what you've got. Overall size and is pretty nice. I think many people looking for a 12-inch display will really like this. And it is attached pretty strong. We do have this little portion here where it seems to be a little bit spring-loaded. So that's something that allows it to sort of extend just a little bit. Now let's get the pen opened up and get this set up. So we'll just lean that like this for now. See what we've got for this. Now, this is fairly expensive as well with this pen. We're over $100. I saw it for about $110 or $120. You can use third-party options as well, but I thought this was pretty expensive. Retail is $129.99. So again, we'll open this one up. If you already have a Surface Pen, you can use it with it though, of course. And then we'll open it up like this. We've got a bunch of paperwork in here, it seems. So maybe a quick start guide before using, things like that. It says what the buttons do, and let's get to the pen itself. So here's the pen. It's what we had before. It does have haptic feedback in it as well, and again, what you would expect. And it does attach on the back. So this time around, it snaps onto the back, and Microsoft has supposedly tested this, so if you place it in a bag, it's not going to come off. And this is really on there pretty firmly. So it's got a little divot it sits in, and it's really not going to come off very easily. So let's go ahead and get this set up. We'll continue in English, and like I said, this is a touchscreen, so we can use that. And then we can add it to our Microsoft account and test out some other things with it. I'll select United States, that's where I am. And then of course we can use the keyboard and trackpad, so we'll select US for here. Of course, select whatever works for you. It says, do you want to add a layout? We'll skip that for now. And then we'll connect to a local network. The overall click force on the trackpad does feel a little bit stronger than what I remember on the previous ones. It's looking for updates, checking for updates. It says just a moment here, so we'll give it a bit. It's installing updates, so it will take a moment here. Now we have to review the license agreement. We'll click accept here. Now we have to name the device. We'll just name it Surface 12. Click next. Now it says we're getting you the latest features. Check out what your new CoPilot Plus PC is capable of while you wait. So we'll go ahead and click next. It says, do you want to try CoPilot on PC? We'll say try now. And it says step one, downloading. So it's installing all of these updates. So basically we have to verify we're human for some reason. And then it walks you through a tutorial of what CoPilot can do for you. So whether that's writing tools or image creation, other things like that. So you'll see we have some options for think deeper, better for more complex topics and more. So need to help structuring your day, it can assist. Now it says more benefits are waiting, just sign in. So we'll go ahead and click continue and we'll get signed in here. Now I'm signed in and it says, do you want to use your face to sign in faster and more securely? We'll say yes for now. We'll set that up. That's one of my favorite features here. So we'll just tilt this up, get my face in frame. And it says, keep looking. That's it. You're all set. So we'll tilt it back down here and we're good to go. We'll tap next and continue with the setup. It says, got it. Now set up a PIN. We'll create a PIN. Now we can choose privacy settings, whether that's location, find my device, diagnostics, and more. We'll just tap next. We'll accept everything here. You can, of course, customize that however you'd like. And now we can restore from my previous PC. So it says it was last backed up. That's my gaming PC. Let's take a look at what we have for options. So we'll go to more options here. And last backed up, last year, the Surface laptop. Let's go ahead and use that. We'll tap continue, and it will restore everything for us. Now it says, let's customize your experience. What do you want to do? Development, entertainment, gaming. We'll do some gaming. We'll say school and maybe creativity as well. So we'll make sure it's set up for that. Maybe some business as well, and then tap accept. So it'll sort of customize it for you. And then you can use your phone from your PC for Android and more. So we'll skip that for now. We can then back up our photos right now and keep them safe. Again, I'll skip that for now. And it says always have access to your recent browsing data. We can accept or say not now. So it will sync things such as Edge. They're giving us a free trial of Microsoft 365 for 1 month, and you can add up to 300 users. Now we can use Microsoft's recall, which was a bit controversial at first, but then we can recall different dates, having it easily back up. We'll say yes, save, but you can turn this off at any time if you'd like. So it says open recall, so that's something we have the option for here. You can see it's set up. Let's get rid of this window here. And it says unlock your photographic memory with recall. Tap next. You're in control of your privacy, so you can change that. And then it says do more with what's on your screen. So again, next, and then tap continue. It says making sure it's you, so we'll do that again. So there you go. Here's the animation for recall. It's now saving snapshots, so you can go back and recover what you might have used before. So let's go ahead and close that. Of course, we have the main desktop here. It looks like exactly what you would expect. We can use the pen here and select or whatever we'd like, go into our settings and take a look at it. So you can go into your Explorer window here, take a look at this PC, right click, and let's go into our properties here. And then in the properties, you can see here, it's got the Snapdragon 8X Plus, or Snapdragon X Plus rather, 8 core, 3.3 gigahertz or 3.24 gigahertz with 16 gigs of RAM. So that's what it has installed by default. Let's go ahead and close this. Everything's been installed, restored, and ready to go. And you can see here we have Geekbench. So it says Snapdragon X Plus, 8 core. And one thing to note is this does not have fans on the back. There's no fans whatsoever, no opening for a vent. So let's go ahead and run the CPU benchmark, and then we'll take a look at the heat as well. Benchmark's completed, and we have 2,210 for single core, 9,560 for multi-core. So that gives you an idea of what it's capable of just running a simple benchmark test. And now that it's run the benchmark test, let's take a quick look at the heat on the back since we don't have a fan, and I have a thermal camera here. It's quite hot on the back of the device. Of course, it's going to try and dissipate that heat through the aluminum. So let's have it sort of reset. We'll flip it over here, and you can see in Fahrenheit, we're at about 110 degrees Fahrenheit. I'll put Celsius in the upper right, but this gives you an idea of how hot it is, the overall thermal signature, and what it looks like altogether. So the processor's up here in the top, and again, it's about 110 to 111 degrees Fahrenheit. So now that we've taken a look at the benchmarks, let's take a listen to the speakers themselves. So I've got the outro music ready to go for this video. I've got a decibel meter, and we've got two speakers here. Let's go ahead and take a listen. The speakers sounded pretty good. They measured around 84 to 85 decibels at the highest point. They didn't seem to distort at all, and bass was actually pretty good, especially when I tilted the display up a bit. It sounded pretty good overall. So I'm pretty happy with that as far as the sound from this, much better than I was expecting at least. Next, let's go ahead and see if we can run Cities Skylines. Now, we can run things such as Xbox streaming with cloud gaming, but let's see if we can even open this up. I've spent over 400 hours playing this game, and we'll see if we can actually launch it, see what it's like. Now, it's done loading. Let's see if we can play it. Maybe zoom in and out here. Let's see if we can move around a little bit. Zoom in, and you'll see this is a city I made before. It's paused currently, and it's locking up a little bit as it's continuing to process. So this gives you an idea of what to expect. There we go. And so it's not really the best thing for gaming, but you could use it for something like this, City Skylines 1. There's no way this could play City Skylines 2 with any sort of speed or anything like that, but it does look like it might be playable. Definitely a little bit choppy, though, as we move around here. So not the greatest frame rates or anything like that, but at least a little bit playable here. Now let's go ahead and exit out of this. We'll quit here, and it did take a very long time to load. So that's one thing I wanted to mention. Also, we do have quite a few smudges on here that I keep having to wipe off just from using it a little bit. So just keep that in mind. I do have a controller here as well to see if it will work. We've got my Elite 2 controller. Again, let's give it a moment and see if it will launch at all. Last year, it didn't work for me. Maybe this time around it will. And trying to load the finals isn't working at all. Last year, I couldn't get Call of Duty to load either. It just sort of crashes and allows you to click play again and doesn't really do anything. So you can click on it. You'll get the initial screen. You can try and open it within Steam as well, and it just won't work. Of course, you could stream games under the Xbox app itself. So it will work with cloud gaming. It looks like it runs okay, but there's a little bit of lag like you would expect, maybe using a controller over the internet, things like that. But it will work if you want to try it out. So games overall will run okay depending on their age. Of course, it will run better if you're using Xbox cloud gaming with the newer games, since this really doesn't have that kind of processor in it or video card. But if we go into maybe an app such as Figma here, we'll just go in here, run this, and I showed this last year as well. Many people ask me to run this, but this should run no problem. You can go in, of course, create whatever you'd like, move things around. You'll see the connections here. Everything seems to work fairly smooth, and it is designed for ARM, this specific version. So again, you can use it, create whatever you'd like. I don't know how to use this app that much, as I haven't really played around with it, but it is something I probably should learn a little bit more. But this gives you an idea that it can run it without a problem. And of course, you could run things such as Word and other programs. One other thing I wanted to mention, though, is the keyboard is backlit. I didn't mention that earlier, but if we turn off the lights here, you'll see that the keyboard is backlit if we hit this button here, and then we have our brightness, of course, with the screen, and everything works as you would expect. So you've got a nice backlit keyboard, something that you don't get on the latest iPad Airs from Apple. So even with the keyboard being about the same price, at least we have a backlit keyboard on this Surface. So I think this device overall is pretty decent. One thing I did want to mention is the overall battery. It does have 45 watt fast charging, 12 hours of active web use, and 16 hours of video playback. So the battery should last okay. But again, this is not a heavy duty PC. If you needed something more high end, you could go for the larger Surface Pro. You could go for the Surface Laptop. But if you need something for gaming, you could go with the AMD or Intel processor versions. So this is something that is decent, great battery life, and is a decent tablet and probably more usable for things such as school. You'll see how fast that unlocked. And overall, I think it's a nice little device, but it is a little expensive, around $1,000. Unless you have specific uses for it, you may want to opt for the faster version with the larger display, with the better resolution, faster refresh rate, and more. Also, one other thing, the camera here. So if we go into the camera app itself, let's open it up and we'll let it access the microphone here. Yes. And let the camera access your location. We'll just say no for now, but it looks okay. It's going to be great for Zoom calls, things like that. And the studio mics have always been pretty good on these devices. You can use touch, you can use the mouse and keyboard and everything else. So I think it's a decent device, something that's very portable, maybe to go along with maybe a gaming PC or something along those lines. Let me know what you think of the new Surface Pro 12-inch in the comments below. If you have any additional questions or if you've picked one up, I'd love to hear from you there as well. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.